All right, so start finding a comfortable seat as we settle in here, getting started on this beautiful Wednesday evening. Finding a comfortable seat, we're gonna get started on our awesome little yoga practice. So wherever you are, just try to find a comfortable seat. Again, just starting with the foundation, so making sure that your sit bones are on the ground. Maybe you're sitting cross-legged. That's not comfortable. Maybe you have your legs out wide. The idea is to really settle in here. Take your time and arrive at the mat. Slowly starting to close your eyes. If you're just joining, take your time and arrive here. So let's start with a couple really deep breaths to let go of it all. So exhale all your air out through your mouth. Really push everything out. And then inhale really deeply through your nose, holding it at the top, and open mouth exhale. Make a little noise. Let's do that two more times. Inhaling really deeply through your nose, holding it at the top, maybe sipping a little bit more air, and then open it out. Last really big one, deepest breath you've taken all day. Inhale, inhale, inhale. And open mouth, super loud. Nice. So keeping your eyes closed if that's comfortable. It just helps us really tune in and settle in here. Making sure your sit bones are getting really deep in the ground, and with the crown of your head, pull up so that your spine is as straight as it can be. Feel your shoulders melting in your back. We made it. We're on our mat. So, as always, let's do a little bit of a check-in. See how we're feeling physically. Here, I really want to call any attention to any little bits of tension, any tightness, anything that is needing a little bit of extra space, a little bit of extra breath. A lot of us are spending a lot of time sitting at home, so maybe that's in your hips, your shoulders. Really just take the time at your own pace to notice any tension. And maybe there's very little tension. You can notice that too. The idea of having our eyes closed and tuning into our body is to, without any judgment, just notice where we're at. Just asking ourselves how we're doing, so that we know what we're in need of and what we can bring throughout the rest of the practice. Taking a couple more breaths, really checking in with our body. Maybe focusing just on one part, maybe on multiple parts. Making sure as we're letting go of that tension, we're still breathing, inhaling through our nose and exhaling through the nose. And then noticing how we're feeling emotionally. If there's anything that come up, any words specifically. Again, just meeting yourself right here, right now. How are you feeling emotionally? What's coming up? And then how are you feeling mentally? or things really crystal clear, and or maybe really foggy. Again, the idea is just to notice what comes up and sit here with it. Not trying to change it. Just being here. And then lastly, noticing our vibrations, our energy. Do you feel really ecstatic and bright? Or maybe you feel really dark and low and slow. Knowing that whatever comes up is okay. Just allowing yourself to feel that. And then bringing one or both hands to your heart, feeling that heartbeat, that drum we all have inside, and connecting to an intention for your practice. So maybe you have an intention you've been working on or something that you already know you want to bring into this practice. Maybe there's somebody that you want to dedicate your practice to. I'll also invite you to think about the time we're in right now, not just this pandemic and all the things we're feeling globally, but also the fact that it's a full moon in Scorpio tomorrow. It's a really beautiful time to let something go and start afresh or new. That could be something as simple as a habit you want to let go of, maybe a relationship, maybe a relationship with yourself or a pattern you keep going back to. Maybe it's a bigger shift. Maybe it's just an inner thought that keeps coming back. Whatever it is, invite you to think about letting that go, letting it be. And you don't have to know what's going to come from letting that go, what new thing is already on its way. Just an idea as we shift into this beautiful full moon tomorrow. So last breath here, really thinking and sealing your intention. Let's do one really deep one again. So inhale through your nose. Inhale the deepest, deepest one yet. And open mouth, let everything go. Slowly open your eyes. And let's get moving. Let's move into a tabletop position. If you can face that way today, that'd be great. Thank you. And then you're slowly going to start moving into your cat and cows. So on an inhale, drop your belly, look up. And on an exhale, round your back. Yeah, leading with that tailbone and then bringing your gaze down. Inhale again. And exhale back into cat. And doing that at your own pace for a couple breaths. Let's do 3 to 5 breaths here. Really noticing how you're feeling in your body, what your spine is up to. Just checking in as we're settling in here. Just one more inhale into cow, and then exhale into cat. And actually one more inhale into cow. And then you're going to tuck your toes and on an exhale, move into your first downward facing dog. Don't settle in here. We're making this still a warm up and really moving through it. So inhale, you're going to drop your knees and come back into a cow pose. Look up. And then exhale, you're going to move into a child's pose. So open your knees out wide. Yeah. So let's do that round all together. So Inhale, come back into cow pose. Exhale, tuck your toes into down dog. Inhale, bring your knees down and into cow. And exhale into child's pose. Let's do that one more cycle. Inhale into cow. Exhale into down dog. Inhale into cow. Exhale, push back into child's pose. Taking a couple breaths here. Maybe rolling your forehead back and forth. And then inhale back into cow. Last one here. And exhale, tuck your toes. Bring your hips back into down dog. This time we'll stay into this down dog for a little bit. So let's settle in here. Come into a plank pose and just check in that your hands and feet are the right distance, and then keeping your hands and feet there, push back, push your hips back into down dog. Yeah, and you're looking for that really straight spine, so please bring as much of a bend in your knee as you need. And then let's start maybe walking your dog here back and forth. Yeah, bending one knee and then the other. And then you're slowly gonna come back to neutral. Yeah, and then you're gonna lift your right foot all the way up and bend that knee, stack the hip, and do some nice hip circles leading with the knee. So those circles can be as little or as wide as your hip is in need of, whatever your body is telling you to. And then slowly start rotating them the other way, your knee the other way. Remembering to breathe throughout. And then bringing that leg down and inhaling your left leg up this time. Bending your knee, stacking the hip. And starting with your little leg circle. They can be, again, start out small and then get bigger. And then slowly rotate them the other way. Staying with your breath here. Yeah, and then bringing that foot back down to your down dog and really slowly walking your feet to your hands at the top of your mat in a forward fold. As we start our sun salutations. So stay in that fold here first. Yeah, maybe grab opposite elbows and really let everything go. Again, maybe that's our theme of class today. Just let it go. Maybe swing your elbows back and forth like a rag doll. You can bend your knees as much as you need to, especially this early on in the practice. And then letting your arms go if you're holding onto your elbows. And inhaling everything up, coming all the way up. Bringing both of your palms to heart center. Breathing here and closing your eyes just for a moment. Remembering that intention. And then opening them, bringing your hands by your sides, and let's start our sun salutation. So on an inhale, you're gonna reach with your arms, maybe give yourself a little back bend. On an exhale, you're gonna fold forward, hinging at the hips. Inhale with a flat back, yeah, half lift. And exhale, bringing your palms to the ground. Moving back into a plank pose and traveling through your vinyasa. Inhaling into an up dog and exhaling into a downward facing dog. Bending your knees a lot, bringing your gaze to your hands and stepping, walking, or hopping to the top of your mat. Forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, and then inhale, both arms up, bringing your palm at heart center. closing your eyes just for a moment. And then let's do that one more time at your own pace. I'll be a guiding voice, but feel free to tune me out for this one and really just listen to your body. Whenever you're ready, inhale up, exhale, forward fold, inhale, halfway lift, flat back, exhale, plant your palms down, move to plank, travel through your vinyasa, up dog, untuck your toes, down dog, and then bending those knees a whole lot, looking up, walking to the top of your mat in a forward fold. And then inhaling everything up, coming back with your palms at heart center. Last little breath here, noticing what it feels like as you're bringing a little bit of fire, a little bit of heat in your body. And then inhale everything up. Here, we're not gonna forward fold. You're gonna bend your knees and sit into a chair pose. So your chair, you can be with your legs touching, all zipped up, or with a hip width distance in your feet, whatever your preference is. Just make sure that you're feeling really stable. So if your toes are reaching up, make sure that you're coming back and bringing the weight in your whole feet, bringing the weight back to the ball of your feet. And then your arms can be as straight as you'd like them to be. They can be in cactus arms, whatever you'd like today. And then exhale everything down. Inhale, halfway lift, and travel through your flow, and we'll meet in a downward facing dog. Whenever I say to travel through your flow, you're welcome to just take a child's pose or go straight into down dog. Please listen to your body. Especially as we're not in a room and I can't see you, you are your inner teacher. So inhale your right foot up this time. Bring your foot in between your hands and rise into a high lunge. So here, your hips are squared, really facing the front of the room. You want to have that front leg 90 degree bend. And then if you can bring that back leg straight, that's great. Inhaling here and exhaling, bringing your palms to heart center. Inhaling to puff up your chest and exhale, rotate to the right, bringing your left elbow to the outside of your right knee. Holding here, strong breath. You can bring that gaze if you'd like to have a deeper twist, bring that gaze over the shoulder. And then inhale, come back to center, arms up. And exhale, cartwheel your hands down and travel through your flow. Once you're in down dog, take an inhale here, exhale. And then on your next inhale, bring that left leg up. Bring that foot in between your hands and rise into your high lunge on the other side. So again, your hips are squared. That back foot is, the heel is lifted. You're really on your toes. That 90 degree bend in your front knee. And then when you're ready, bring your palms to touch at heart center. Inhale, really puff up, open up that chest. Exhale, twist and lower, bringing your right elbow to the outside of your left knee. You're always welcome to bring that back knee down. Really please listen to that body of yours. Connecting to your breath here as you're holding this pose. And then on your next inhale, come back to center, bring your arms back up, and exhale, travel through your flow. Taking your time here to really go through every pose. And once you're back in downward facing dog, lift that right leg up this time, bring that foot back in between your hands. Rise again in that high lunge, really connecting to your squared hips facing forward. And then here, we're gonna do a little eagle wrap with our arms. So bring your right arm under your left. It can be just hugging if your elbows are touching and you wanna just reach your hands back to your shoulders, or otherwise wrap your wrists around as well. And then on your next inhale, you're gonna bring yourself back, reaching back, giving yourself a little back bend here. And holding here, staying strong. And then on an exhale, unwrap your arms, bring your arms back into an airplane wing, and then you're slowly gonna start lifting or bringing the weight into your right foot, and then lifting that left foot up, making sure your hips are squared, and coming into your airplane. Breathing here, bring the gaze out far in front of you, so that it can help reach that back leg. You can bend your right knee as much as you need to. And then inhale, come back into that high lunge. Reach, reach, reach. And exhale, travel through your flow. Nice work, everybody. Take your time as you flow it out. Take a couple breaths here in down dog. And then on your next inhale, lift that left leg up. Bring that foot in between your hands and rise into your high lunge again on the other side. So here, as we did our eagle wrap on one side, we're gonna do it on the other. So making sure this time your left arm is the one that goes under. And again, it can just be at your elbows and hugging yourself or going for the wrap. Inhale, reach back, open that chest, give yourself a nice back bend. Breathing here. And then you're slowly gonna start unraveling your arms, bringing them back into airplane wings and shifting all of the weight of your body into that left foot, left leg. And then slowly pushing yourself up, flying away on that left leg. That left leg can have as much of a bend in the knee as you need. You can fall out and come back. Breathing deeply and exhaling back into your high lunge. Inhale, little back bend, and exhale, cartwheel your hands down. And flow it out. Nice work. Taking a couple deep breaths in down dog. Feel free to really open mouth, exhale, and let everything go. And then when you're feeling ready, inhale that right leg up. Bring it in between your hands. And this time you're gonna flip that back leg so that it's on the ground, ready for warrior two. And inhale up into your warrior two stance. So in that high lunge, your hips were really facing forward. Here you're gonna open them up and make sure that your foot, the inside of your arch, of your left arch, is basically aligned with your right heel. And then your arms are straight out into a T. Your gaze is facing forward, making sure that that back arm is just as high as that front one. Channeling your inner warrior here, whatever that warrior is gonna help you let go of. And then on an inhale, you're gonna flip your front palm. Reach, reach, reach as far as you can. And then exhale, keeping those legs as they are. Exhale back and reverse your warrior. So So here the idea is really that nice side body stretch, making sure that your gaze is up, maybe looking towards your hand. Taking nice deep breaths. And then on an inhale, you're gonna come back to warrior two. You're gonna straighten your front leg out, bring your hip out, and exhale into your triangle pose. So triangle pose, you wanna make sure that your right leg is completely straight. And then you wanna make sure that your arm is up and that your gaze is up as well. If having that leg out straight is proving difficult, then just shorten your stance. And you don't have to have your hand inside your shin. It can really be inside your knee or wherever you're able to land it. One more breath here. And inhale, come back to warrior two. We're gonna move into our side angle pose. So side angle, you can bring your right elbow to your knee and reach up. If you'd like a little bit more, then straighten out that right hand. Breathing really deeply here. And then if you want even more, bring that left arm to frame your ear. And the last strong moment, lifting that right hand to frame your right ear. A little bit of core here. Breathing, you've got this. And exhale, come back to warrior two. And cartwheel your hands down and travel through your flow. Nice work. Let's take a really deep breath here in down dog. You know what's coming on the other side. All right, inhale your left leg up. Bring your foot in between your hands and rise into warrior two on the other side. Yeah, so checking in again with those arms. Making sure that your gaze is forward, that your hips are opened up. Breathing here, really channeling that inner warrior, feeling this pose on the other side. And then on your next inhale, you're gonna flip your palm forward and reach, reach, reach as far as you can, making sure that those legs don't move as you exhale. Exhale and reverse your warrior. Nice work. And here you can bring your gaze up to your hand or to the ceiling or maybe the sky if you're outside. One more breath here. And then you're gonna exhale, come back into a warrior two. You're gonna straighten out that front leg and bump your hip back and exhale into your triangle pose. Making sure that your gaze is up, that you're feeling that nice side body stretch. Again, if you need to bend that knee, then just shorten out your stance or bring your hand maybe a little bit closer to your knee. And then exhale here, come back into a warrior two. We're almost there. And then you're gonna move into that side angle pose. So either bringing your elbow to your knee or maybe bringing your leg out straight. And your arm is reaching straight up at first. Inhale here. And then if you'd like a little bit more, exhale. Bring your right arm to frame your ear. Breathe deeply. Connect to whatever your intention is. And then bring your left arm up for that last strong, really nice core. You got this. We're almost there. Last inhale and come back to warrior two. And cartwheel your hands down. Travel through your flow. Nice work. Exhale into down dog, taking a couple of breaths here before we do our last standing poses. Inhale, bring your right leg up, bring it in between your hands, and open up into your warrior two. So as you're here in this warrior two, we're gonna move into a half moon pose, channeling a little bit of moon for that full moon coming. So as you're here, the idea when we were in airplane mode, you were really stacking your hips and here, or you're really squaring your hips. Here the idea is to stack your hips. So you're gonna bring the weight into that right foot. Imagine that your arm or your hand is gonna fall to the right upper corner of your mat, and you're slowly gonna bring that weight into that right foot and lift into a half moon pose. Maybe your arm comes down. The idea and what you're really looking for, or the feeling you're looking for, is for eventually that left hip to be on top of that right hip. So just like you're in a warrior two when you're standing, making sure that your hips are super open. You can bend that front knee as much as you need to. Maybe fall out and come back. And then exhale, come back into a warrior two. And cartwheel your hands down. Travel through your flow. Nice work. Your next inhale, you're gonna lift your left leg up. Bring it in between your hands and open up to a warrior two on this side. Yeah. So taking your time to really settle into that warrior two. And then you know where you're going and that feeling that you're trying to have of really stacking that right hip this time on the left. So on an inhale, you're slowly gonna start bringing the weight into your left leg and then lifting off and stacking that hip onto the other. Maybe falling and coming back, breathing and smiling through it if you can. And maybe today your foot just comes off a little bit and that's perfect. That's all your body needs today. And then exhale, come back into warrior two. Cartwheel your hands down and travel through your flow. Once you're in a down dog, you're gonna come into a child's pose. Let's all take a little bit of breaths here. Your child pose can be with your knees open out wide or maybe touching and your arms by your side. Forehead on the ground. Letting it all go. Just taking a moment to recenter before we start moving again. Noticing what happens to your mind as your body becomes still. Just noticing. No judgment. And then inhale back into a downward facing dog when you're ready. And then we're just gonna move through to plank pose. And we're gonna do just a little bit of side plank here. So you're gonna wanna bring that left palm right under your face and stack your right foot on your left and open up that right arm. If you'd like, you can bring your left knee down. Again, just listen to your body and what you're in need of today. If you want more, and lift that right leg up and maybe bring your right arm to frame your ear. And then when you're ready, exhale back into a normal plank and eventually move into a side plank on your right. So bringing that right hand again, right under your face, stacking the left foot on top of the right, noticing if your hips are dropping, bringing that knee down if you need it, that's completely fine. And breathing strongly, and then if you want a little bit more, lifting that top leg up, that arm framing the ear, and exhale, come back into plank pose, and travel through your flow. Nice work. Take really deep exhales and inhales in your down dog. And then you're slowly gonna bring your knees to the mat. We're gonna start getting on the floor now. And you're gonna stand up on your knees, moving through our camel pose. So as you're here, standing up on your knees, yeah, you're gonna bring your hands to your lower back and take your time getting into this pose, but on an inhale, really let your eyes gaze, come to the ceiling, and then opening up that heart and giving yourself a nice back opener, reaching back just as far as you need. Maybe your hands come down and they reach for your feet. Inhaling here, feeling that beautiful heart opener. And then when you're ready, bringing your hands back to your lower back, coming back to center, and then sitting your sit bones on your feet in hero's pose for a moment. If this is really uncomfortable, feel free to put a pillow in between your sit bones and your shins. And let's close our eyes for a moment, bringing one hand on your heart, the other one on your belly. Recentering. Coming back to our intention. Coming back to whatever got us on the mat today. Noticing what's happening, how the energy is shifting in our body as we're building heat and then slowing down. One more breath here. And exhale, open your eyes. You're just gonna plop your hips onto one side and bring your legs out in front of you into a forward fold. So here you can have your legs out straight or maybe have it bent in the knee. The idea is that just as you're hinging from the hips in a standing forward fold, that's what you want in a seated one. So inhale your arms all the way up and exhale, hinging at the hips. And then once you can't hinge anymore, just let your arms fall wherever they do. Maybe today that's reaching your thighs or your knees, or maybe you're getting a little bit closer to your feet. And then just letting go of that head. Again, if you need to bend your knees, even if it's just for extra support, just listen to your body today. And then let go as your forehead hangs heavy. And when you're ready, slowly come back. And you're gonna bring your feet out into a butterfly. So making sure that the soles of your feet are touching. And you can bring your hands to your feet and push on your knees with your elbows. Open up those hips a little bit more. And then maybe you want to bring this into a really deep forward fold, walking your hands out in front of you. Again, just letting your gaze fall to the ground, maybe closing your eyes and letting your head hang heavy. Taking some really nice deep breaths here. And then coming back up, you're gonna bring your sit bones to the middle of the mat. And then bring your legs up for a little bit of core. Bring your arms out by your side. And we're just gonna do five where we lower down and hover and then come back up with our knees into our chest. So inhale deep and lower, hover, and exhale, come back. That's two, three more. Two more here. Inhale in, exhale down, last one. Nice work. And then just keeping those legs up, bringing your hands to touch. You're gonna reach both of your palms to the left, look over your left shoulder, come back and twist to the right, looking over the right shoulder, coming back. Two more on each side. Inhale left, exhale center. Inhale right, exhale center. Last one on each side, left side. Inhale center, right side. Inhale center, nice work. Bringing your feet down and then lowering the upper body. Rose loving today's class, I can tell. I hope you're all feeling good wherever you are. We're not doing Shavasana yet. You can lower that lower part, top part of your body, but making sure to keep your knees bent, the soles of your feet on the ground. And then we're going to bring one hand to your heart, one hand to your belly, closing your eyes for a moment here again. And bring your knees to touch and your feet out wide. And then open your eyes, and we're gonna do a different type of pigeon pose. We're gonna do figure four today. So what that looks like is really just the pose reversed. So you wanna bring your right foot to the left knee. And then you can inhale that up. You can reach back your back thigh, your left back thigh, with one or both of your hands. Maybe if you want a little bit more, you can push it with your left hand, and then with your right hand, push your knee further out. You can straighten out that left leg, or maybe keep it to the ground and just let it hang there. Just really taking time to give that hip some extra love. Making sure that all of your back, that lower back, is really still on the ground. We're going to take some really deep breaths and stay in this pose for a little while. Noticing you can bring your knee a little bit closer to your nose every breath. can let go of tension in your hip with every exhale. Couple more really deep breaths here. Again, just noticing what happens to your mind as your body becomes still. And then if your eyes are closed, open them up. Bring that right foot back to the ground. Maybe shake your legs out before switching over to the other side. Bringing that left foot on top of your knee. I like to flex my foot, but it's up to you. And then inhale, reaching that back thigh. And then noticing whatever you did on the other side, you don't have to do the same, but you're welcome to straighten out your leg, or maybe keep that right foot on the ground, maybe that's a deep enough stretch. Closing your eyes here for a moment. Taking the time to notice where you're holding tension and where you can let go of whatever you're holding on to. The longer we hold a pose, the more breaths we bring into that pose, the deeper we can go. Sometimes our mind makes us go straight to the next one or the next movement. But if we come back to our breath, we know that we can stay a little bit longer and grow a little bit deeper. And if your eyes are closed, start opening them up. Bring your feet back to the ground. And we're just gonna travel through a couple bridges. So let's start getting into that pose. Bringing your feet as close to your sit bones as possible. You want to try to reach them with your fingertips. And then once you're ready, and making sure those feet are hip width distance. And then when you're ready on your inhale, you're going to start lifting from the hips. Lifting all the way up. And then maybe clasping your hands and giving your shoulders a little massage here. Making sure that your knees aren't going out crazy wide. Pretend that you have a block in between your knees that you're squeezing onto. Squeezing those glutes. And slowly exhale vertebrae by vertebrae as you came up. Closing your eyes. Bringing your knees to touch and your feet open wide. One hand on your heart, one hand on your belly. Breathing here. And then slowly open your eyes up again. And here we're gonna do one more round of bridge, or if full wheel is a part of your practice, feel free to do that. I'm gonna walk through it if you'd like to try. So the idea is that you really want to have your feet just as close to your sit bones, just like you're getting into bridge pose. And if you are, this is perfect. And then you wanna bring your hands out by your ears to frame your head. Making sure that your fingertips are facing your shoulders. And then on an inhale, you're slowly going to start pushing from your feet and bringing your hips up just like you would in bridge. And then the next part is that you want to push off with your arms and rise up. Breathing here. Little by little. Taking yourself all the way up. And then exhaling, lowering that top body first if you're in full wheel. And then lowering your hips all the way down. And again, bringing your eyes to close and your knees to touch, your feet out wide, changing whatever hand was on your heart, moving it to your belly. Breathing deeply. And then flick your eyes open. We're going to move through some spinal twists here. So on an inhale, you want to bring both of your knees to the left side. Yeah, and you can bring them out, having 90 degree bend in your knees, making sure that your gaze is looking to the right, that your right arm is straight out. And maybe your left hand is just it can be straight out, or maybe it's helping your knees twist a little deeper. Just breathing here, really making sure that your gaze is opposite to wherever your knees are. Noticing what it feels like to twist on the side. Maybe bringing your eyes to a close. You take some deeper and longer breaths here in these positions as we are on our mat, all limbs touching the mat. And then slowly inhale back to center. Bringing your feet back to the ground. And then inhale, twisting to the right. Bringing your knees out to the right. And then bringing your left hand on the ground, opposite side of your knees, and bringing your gaze to face that left side. Maybe your right hand is helping push your knees a little bit deeper into the twist. Again, feel free to close your eyes here. Breathing through it. Last couple breaths. And then inhale, come back to center. Bring your knees out into your chest. Give yourself a really, really big hug here. You can rotate left to right, giving your spine a little bit of love. And then bringing your feet into your hands and opening them up into a happy baby, opening those legs up. Maybe straightening out one leg and then the other, rotating back and forth into our happy baby pose. Breathing deep. And then letting go whenever you're ready, letting go of those feet. And here I invite you, if you'd like, to move through shoulder stand. Otherwise, if there's any other inversion that's calling your name, go for it. So here in shoulder stand, what you're gonna wanna do is push your upper body up so that you're creating a little tripod with your elbows. And then you want to straightening out those legs as much as you can. Inhale really deeply here. Maybe as you exhale, you reach your feet and your legs back. Maybe your feet even touch the ground behind you. Maybe you open up your knees and you frame your head. Noticing what it feels like to have your hips over your head, have that blood flowing the other direction. And then when you're ready, exhale those hips back to the mat. And slowly start getting ready for our last pose, our Shavasana. Really let everything go. This is your time. Is your time of deep rest. Know that everything you've done up to this point has led us to this exact moment. Closing your eyes if they're not already, and just naturally falling into a lying down position. Noticing what's happening with your breath and your mind, and then just letting it go, knowing that you have nothing to worry about, and I will call you out when it's time. Enjoy this moment of deep relaxation. And slowly, when you're ready, start coming back into this space. Maybe moving your fingertips and your toes. Start bringing movement back into your body, and eventually, still with those eyes closed, coming into a fetal position on the right side of your body, holding yourself one more time before moving into seated. Giving yourself that extra moment of love. And then eventually exhaling back into seated, keeping those eyes closed, just meeting us where we first started this class, this practice. So noticing here in seated, any shift that has happened physically in your body. Just noticing where you are feeling any shifts, any remaining tension, maybe aggravated, who knows, whatever. Hopefully this practice has brought in a little bit more space if there was a place with tension. But maybe it's calling your attention in another place in your body, just noticing, and then coming back to our emotional body, noticing what we're feeling, what comes up, again, without any judgment. Noticing mentally how we're feeling. And lastly, how our energy is. What are our vibrations like after this practice? The idea is just to notice what taking this time, what it brings you. And to remember that this practice is always available. You can always come back to your mat, even if it's for 5 minutes, if you need it that moment. And let's bring our hands to our heart, feeling that heartbeat. Feeling immense gratitude for ourselves first, for really taking the time to practice. And then bringing your palms to touch, lifting them at your third eye, that space in between your eyebrows, and bowing down in gratitude. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining today's practice. I hope that it brought to you whatever you're in need of. And I hope that this beautiful full moon tomorrow will help you let go of anything you're in need of letting go. My name is Magali, and thank you so much to Decathlon USA for putting this on. I am a yoga teacher and also co-founder of Atlas Go. If you'd like, this practice can help plant a tree. So feel free to go on atlasgo.org and download our application, join the Gopher Trees Challenge if you're not there already, and you can add your yoga practice. Thank you so much, and Ollie will help me.